Hello and welcome to the online learning session ABB Free at Home, DALI and Split Unit Gateway in Practice. Our online learning session takes around 30 minutes. It's always a special topic. And today we talk about the integration of the DALI Gateway and the Split Unit Gateway into Free at Home. My name is Thorsten Reibel from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings. And together with us is Martin Vichari, and he will present today this topic. Yeah, as always, we record the session. Yeah, we continue now with the topic Free at Home, ABB Free at Home. Today, the DALI and Split Unit Gateway. I would like to hand over to Martin now, and he will continue.
Yeah, hello, everyone, and thank you, Thorsten, for the introduction. Thank you all for joining. Yeah, the topic for today is the DALI Gateway and the Split Unit Gateway from Free at Home. So let's have directly a look at the agenda. So as you can see, we have not too many topics for today. So for both devices, I want to give you a general introduction. So what are the key facts? What are the main features? And how can we install the devices? And after that, we want to have a look at the commissioning part and also, of course, at operation. So how can we control both devices and how we can integrate both devices into our Free at Home system? So let's start first of all with some general words about both devices. So Free at Home, or the main aspect of Free at Home, is that this is an easy to use home automation system which affects different parts of buildings, so especially lighting, blinds, HVAC systems and door communication. So here the DALI gateway and the Split Unit gateway affects more or less the parts or the segments of lighting and HVAC control. And here the approach was, of course, also to give our customers again a holistic solution for building automation systems. So here Free at Home was already in a good position before we had both devices. Now we add both devices and we close here also an important gap in our portfolio. So let's start with the DALI gateway first of all. So what are the main functions of the DALI gateway? So first of all, it's of course an interface between our DALI system and our Free at Home system. We have an integrated DALI power supply. And from the functional point of view and also from the commissioning, we have here more or less the same functions, the same parameters available like you use for a normal dimmer from Free at Home. Yeah, up to 16 DALI lamps can be integrated here per each DALI gateway. And these are so more or less the main functions for the DALI gateway. So the supply voltage for the DALI gateway is from 100 volt to 230 volt. So we have we have here the inputs for the live and the neutral. We have on the top side the output for the DALI gateways, and here we can now connect up to 16 DALI devices for this channel. So what are the main advantages for the DALI gateway? So first of all, we have a very simple installation and also the commissioning is very easy. So this is really the main aspect of the DALI gateway. So you will see we don't have any special or complicated features integrated. The DALI gateway behaves really like a normal dimmer. So here really the easiness and the simple installation and commissioning was in the focus. We have one LED for the device on and for the DALI error, and we have also here a very easy manual operation integrated or available, can be activated by pressing the button which you see here on the device for more than 2 seconds or 2 seconds and more, and the manual operation will also end automatically after 5 minutes. Important to know is maybe that when the in this time when the manual operation is activated, that no telegrams from Free at Home will be executed. Only after the manual operation ends, the last received telegram will be more or less executed. So this are the main advantages of the DALI gateway, which we have here. Of course, ABB has a lot of experience when it comes to DALI, especially for the integration with KNX. So most of you will probably know some of our KNX DALI gateways. And so some of the features also like the manual operation are more or less the same like we know it from the KNX DALI gateway. Good, so the second device we want to talk today about is the split unit gateway. So of course here the main function or the main reason why we have this device is we want to integrate split units into our Free at Home system, or we want to control these split units which are installed somewhere in our house with our Free at Home system. So here split units are also a very important aspect, or it was a very, more or less a gap in our portfolio which we wanted to close. So here we are also very happy that we can now also integrate these split units into our Free at Home system. So what is a split unit? Very easy, I think all of you will probably know it. Split units are air conditioning units. Mainly used for cooling a room, of course, can also be used for heating, but I think mainly used for cooling. And these split units are basically installed, controlled with an infrared remote control. And here we have now our split unit gateway with an IR infrared transmitter with a cable. So this way we can now integrate our Free at Home system with our split unit gateway and control now our split units which are installed. So as I said, the basic or mainly when you use a split unit in your house or in your project, then the operation goes via a remote control, and we now replace more or less this remote control. So the remote control should not be used anymore after or when you integrate the split unit into your Free at Home system, then you can really take the remote control and put it somewhere in the cabinet or I don't know where. And then the split unit will be really controlled by using, for example, different sensors like our panel, normal Free at Home sensor, so to control it with scenes, for example, or of course also with the Free at Home app, it's possible. Good, so what is the product about? So we have here really a small pill, which only needs also the voltage from Free at Home, so only the bus voltage is needed. And so as I said, we have an infrared cable here integrated on the device, which has to be put on the receiver of the split unit, so that the split unit gateway itself also has to be installed somewhere next to the split unit. You have, as I said, a 2-meter cable, and this cable must be put here on the receiver of the split unit. Good, so this were first of all some main aspects and features of both devices. So let's have a look now at the commissioning and also of operation of both devices. So we start here first of all with the DALI gateway. So first of all, what are the main functions which we have here on the Free at Home side? First of all, we can control up to 16 DALI devices. And this DALI devices or this DALI lamps, ballasts, however, will be also automatically found and addressed by the DALI gateway. So as soon as you have connected here 16 lamps, for example, all these lamps will be addressed and visualized here directly in the device settings of the DALI gateway. So you don't have to search them, you can't address them, this will also be done automatically. Then we have first of all two settings for the gateway itself. So these are the main parameters which you also see here on the top side from the device management menu. this is first of all the power on level. So this is more or less the brightness value after a supply voltage recovery of the DALI device. And we have here the second option, the second parameter, which is the system failure level. So this is the reaction of the DALI device in case of a free at home voltage failure. So these are first of all the two main parameters for the DALI gateway itself. Then we have, of course, for each channel, some parameters, some adjustments which we can fulfill here. And this are really the same parameters you maybe already know from the free at home dimmer. So really the same parameters here. We have the minimum brightness. We have the maximum switch on brightness at the day and in the night. And we also have the switch off time duration available here. Then the switch on mode. Also last brightness or maximum brightness, both possible. And yeah, as I said, same features, same parameters like for the normal free at home dimmer. Good, so this is then mainly the commissioning part. So what we have to do now is, of course, we have to place and link the DALI devices. So here really nothing what is very special about the DALI gateway. The lamps can be placed by drag and drop them to one of your rooms in your free at home project, and then you can link them with some sensors. You can of course put them in time schedules. You can create some logic functions with the actions, and of course you can also control these lamps with your panel or with your app. So here really same functionality like a normal dimmer. So here really no special topics which we can show here. As I said, the most important aspect for the DALI gateway for us was to make it easy and not too complicated. And here you can see that really the commissioning part is very, very easy for the DALI gateway. Nevertheless, three main troubleshooting aspects, which I want to just tell you very short. So first of all, as I said, the addressing of the DALI ballast is completely done automatically. This also means that if you have maybe an address conflict, or you have wrong status visible from one of the DALI ballasts, then you can always use the reset function of the DALI gateway, and after this reset, all DALI ballasts will be more or less addressed again, and also the status of the ballasts will be sent to free at home again, so that you have really the right addresses and the right status is also available. So just navigate to device management, to the DALI gateway which you want to reset, click on maintenance, and then this pop-up or this window will appear, and here you can select then reset, and this will reset all the DALI gateway and will also readdress all the DALI ballasts. Then a second thing what could be maybe a problem of the DALI gateway or one of the ballasts is related to the minimum brightness of the DALI lamp which you use. So if the minimum brightness which is set up in the free at home interface, so the minimum brightness which you give to one channel, to one lamp, is lower than the physical minimum of the brightness or the minimum brightness of the DALI lamp. So some manufacturers have a higher physical minimum brightness than what you can select and adjust here in the free at home interface. Then this DALI lamps could also be displayed as channel error or as a broken channel. So here in this case, you have to increase the minimum brightness and restart the DALI gateway again. So the workaround is really restart the gateway, set the minimum of the channel which is affected to a higher minimum level, restart the gateway, and then test if the ballast is working correctly now. So if you have this case where you have maybe problems with some channels, with some DALI lamps, then also the minimum brightness could be a reason. So this is always one aspect which you can check if you have problems here. Yeah, another thing is just a simple lamp fold. So really, if you have some problems with the wiring, so if the connection is wrong or not set up correctly, then you will also get a notification in Free at Home. So you will really see general malfunction and that one of the channels. So you also see which channel sends this error message. And here in this case, you should first of all check the wiring and also, of course, the DALI lamp itself. Okay, so this was more or less already all regarding the DALI gateways. So let's now have a look at the split unit gateway. First of all, which functions are available? In general, we can control with Free at Home all functions from a split unit, depending, of course, on the split unit itself. So Free at Home can, for example, switch on and off the split unit. You can adjust the set point. You can change the operating mode, the fan speed, the sled adjustment, and also the activation of the silent mode. But this depends, of course, this is always dependent on the split unit itself. Means if the split unit model doesn't support a silent mode or a sled adjustment, then this is of course also not available in Free at Home. So this is always depending on the split unit model which you use. So for the configuration or the commissioning, here some more steps are needed in comparison to the DALI gateway, but it's also not too complicated. So first of all, we have to place here our split unit gateway in our devices menu. The detection or the split unit gateway will also be addressed or will be located directly or will be visible directly in the Free at Home interface as soon as it's connected to the Free at Home bus. So here you can select then the split unit gateway which you want to add. And the first step is always then to select the remote control of the split unit which you control. So when you click on the icon for the split unit gateway, you will find on the right side then the options for the gateway. And here you have the button remote control. Then you can select the remote control which you usually would use for your split unit gateway for your split unit. So here, really very important, we don't choose the model of the split unit. We really use the remote control which you would usually use for this split unit. So here I selected one example a remote control. Then you confirm this setting, and then you can first of all adjust some further settings in the parameters. So we have first of all a set point limitation for the temperature, so minimum and maximum. You can say yes or no, and then you have the settings for the silent mode in the night, and always send infrared commands only at change depending if you or is needed if you use or if you have a parallel operation with the remote control. So in this case you should change this to send infrared always, but here we definitely recommend really to put the remote control into the cabinet and only use the Free at Home operation. Good, so what is the situation or what happens if the remote control which you want to use or which you would usually use is not available in the Free at Home interface, not available in the list? Then of course new remote controls can be also added to the Free at Home system. Important for you to know is that ABB doesn't guarantee that the remote control can be integrated into Free at Home. So this depends a little bit on the infrared protocol, which is integrated here or integrated to the split unit remote control. But if you say, okay, this remote control is not integrated yet, can we please integrate this remote control? Then please contact the local sales organization in your country. And here, or the local sales will then contact our development department in Poland, and they will check if the remote control can be integrated or not. Which remote controls are already available can be you can check here via this link. So when we share this presentation today, then you can find here a list of all integrated remote controls. So last topic for today, the operation of the split unit gateway. So which different possibilities we have to operate the split unit gateway? First of all, we have the operation via the room temperature controller. Here, very important to mention that the room temperature controller from FreeAtHome is not designed to control a split unit gateway. And this is also the reason why, or if you want to use the RTC to control the split unit gateway, you have only the possibility to adjust the set point of the split unit gateway or of the split unit. So what we have to do, we have to link the RTC, of course, with the split unit. And then you have the possibility to adjust the set point with the RTC. Important is that when you link both systems, the most of the features or most of the settings of the RTC will now disappear in the FreeAtHome user interface, because as soon as they are connected, you really have to go on site and adjust the set point directly on the panel. Here, no more functions, no more parameters, no direct operation is possible anymore on the FreeAtHome side. The only thing you can adjust is then the LED backlight in the night and in the day. So if there is a second, more or less HVAC system, a radiator, a floor heating or whatever in the room where you want to use the RTC with the split unit, then you really have to use also a second RTC. So you see here in my screenshot, here in the screenshot that I've connected the RTC with the split unit gateway, and I have here a second radiator in the room, and now it's not possible anymore to link the RTC with the radiator. So you see here, this is gray, I cannot establish a connection between both systems. So here I really have to add a second RTC, and this one I can connect now to my radiator. So this means really, if you have a situation where you have a split unit and maybe a second heating system in the room available, then you really have to use also two RTCs for this room. So this is also why we say, okay, it's not really recommended to use the RTC for the split unit, better use maybe the panel or use the app. So this is also the second operation which I want to show you now. So the operation via the panel. In general, we can say we have one control element for the split unit available on the panel. And meanwhile, all FreeAtHome panels can also be used to control the split unit gateway. So the 4.3-inch panel, the IP touch panel, 7-inch and 10-inch, and also the 7-inch FreeAtHome panel can be used. Important is that you install, of course, the newest update for all of, or the newest firmware for all of these panels, then you have definitely this split unit control element available. So this control element can just be dragged and dropped to the panel like you know it from all the other functions which you want to add to the panel, and in live or when you really control this this control element for the split unit, it looks like this. So here you have, again, depending on the remote control which you use or which split unit you use, you have the different functions available. You can adjust the set point and you can also adjust the fan here. So here one impression from the 4.3-inch panel. If you use the 7-inch or the 10-inch IP touch or the 7-inch FreeAtHome panel, then the control element itself looks the same. Good, and the last possibility to control the split unit gateway is of course our FreeAtHome app. So here our new FreeAtHome Next app. So you see we have here a quite user-friendly and easy design, and what is also new with the FreeAtHome Next app, that also adjustments for the split unit are possible. So you have here the possibility to navigate also to the settings of the split unit in the bedroom here and do some adjustments really in the settings of the split unit gateway. So the operation itself looks like this. So you have first of all, of course, the possibility to do the set point adjustment. You can adjust the fan settings. You can adjust the mode of the split unit. You can change the swing mode here on the right side, or you can, of course, also turn the split unit off completely. And you see also here, when I select now the settings, then you will find this menu more or less for the split unit gateway. So you see that you can really adjust here now also the temperature limitation, for example, or also the settings for the night mode. Here also important for the split unit gateway that when you want to operate this via the app, then please make sure that all the new software versions of Free at Home and also of the Free at Home Next app are installed, because in the first version of the Free at Home Next app we had some bugs in the integration of the split unit gateway. So here make sure that all the newest software versions are installed, and then you have the control element completely available here for the split unit gateway. Okay, and last, some further settings for the split unit gateway. So first of all, we can of course also link the split unit gateway with some window contacts from Free at Home. So here in this case, if the window will be opened, then the split unit will automatically activate the standby mode. And the second thing is that we can, of course, also use the split unit gateway in scenes. Here, important to know that when you want to create, for example, a cooling scene, then you have to link the scene with the split unit gateway and really adjust the status which you want to have, or the status which the split unit gateway should have. So this must be really defined here, the actual status, and then save the scene, and then you can call the scene, for example, with an sensor from Free at Home. Okay, so this was everything from my side, and I think I can hand back now to Thorsten.
Yeah, thanks, Martin. Great. So we have now also DALI and a split unit solution. Yeah, possible to be integrated in Free at Home. I think both are applications you need more and more. Also in residential projects, where mainly Free at Home is in use. Yeah, and easy to implement, in my opinion. Allow me to show my last slides, as always. Of course, you have all the information around Free at Home on the homepage at the microsite of ABB Free at Home. Have a look. A lot of information are existing, as well as in our training and qualification database, and now more and more also Free at Home. So there's another session tomorrow for Free at Home, the webinar. I come to this very soon. Yeah, training qualification calendar at the moment a bit empty because the year is more or less over. We have only online sessions inside, but we are really planning for the next year also for presence trainings. We will see what is possible, but we continue with our content for online learning sessions and webinars, of course. Will be then visible also in the training and qualification calendar. We plan also certified trainings next year. We will see when it's possible. Most probably not the first half of 2021, any presence trainings, but we will inform if something is changing. Yeah, and as mentioned, we have a further session tomorrow, a webinar, so a bit longer, 1 hour webinar as always, around Free at Home, interfacing with third-party systems. We are local API, application programming interface, the topic. Really nice topic. If you're interested in, please join us tomorrow in the morning, in the afternoon, 1 hour, and you get a lot of interesting information. Yeah, and next sessions and online learning sessions are not directly planned, but of course continued in next year, as mentioned. We will inform you. And I say thank you for your participation. Hope to see you tomorrow. With a further topic around Free at Home, otherwise next year. Thank you for your participation. See you. Bye-bye. Ciao.